俺は過去を切り捨てる。絶対に切らせやしねえ。やれぞ！
Hey, what's up guys, Indian Sensei here. Welcome back to another episode of Ninja Voltage. So, as I promised during the live stream, that a lot of people were asking, like, can you please explain all of the stuff that's happening inside anniversary, the part 1 of 4th anniversary. So, this is officially the part 1 of 4th anniversary, and part 2 is probably gonna start on 10th of December, because that's when the roundup mission goes away, the roundup banner goes away. So I think most probably the part 1 is gonna long for this whole month till 10th of December. On part 2, again we will get the same pattern, you know, roundup, then AOM and then SAM. I am making this video to summarize anniversary in as less time as possible, and I will be covering up all the things that I have noted down in a notepad so that I don't miss anything important. So yeah, let's go. So first of all, we are starting with login bonus. So you can see 200 Shinobites are gonna come our way eventually using login bonus. We have some kind of 5-star ticket which can be used for summoning on a particular banner. We also have a stat card which we'll be getting tomorrow. So again, and daily 10x tickets, this is also a summoning thing. We are getting these tickets for summoning. And this is the Supreme Shinobi login bonus which is going on like past 3-4 days. And yeah, and also we got the 300 Shinobites from the poll, so you might have got those in your present box, so to check it. Also, we have now panel missions for 4th anniversary. Basic stuff you have to do, and play quiz and login 5 times, yeah, blah blah blah. So you get overall of like 200 Shinobites from there, and one stat card after you complete the sheet 1. And roundup panel mission as usual is still there, and we get a key at the end of it. Now coming on to the capacity of Ryo and Chakra has been increased. This is like 6, 9 and 11 digits, so this is too much. Too much Ryo and Chakra can be stored now. Yeah, it's good, it's good. And now one more thing you might have seen, that Shrine stockpile LP. So what is this? This is basically a additional stack of LP you can stock. You can stack here inside the Shrine. It automatically increases slowly. One LP takes like 5 minutes to stock, right? It is, but if you use some kind of this, like crystal, the stockpile time will be reduced accordingly. So yeah, that's like these all the colors have different time to them. You can just click on it and see which. I don't think these are useful as of now, but yeah, keep it for later. So if you accept this, like if I accept, then all the stockpiled LP will be transferred to the main LP. So yeah, this is a good feature, especially for during roundup missions. So yeah, and now you don't have to do anything for this. Just it will automatically keep happening. It will automatically pile LP. So just make sure that whenever you reach 200, just you use your LP and accept this so that it starts from zero again, so that you are not wasting the time. Because yeah, it's literally restoring one LP every 5 minutes. So yeah, it's good for us. Yeah. Better than nothing, right? Same goes for a bank. Now in bank you can store ninja cards. What this means is, like for example, if you have extra cards lying around and you don't want to like increase your inventory limit, what you can do is put your cards in storage. You just have to click on a card and deposit. So what will it do? It will reduce the inventory amount. Like right now I had like 929 cards out of 930, so I want a little space. So what I will do, I will just click on it, deposit, and it will be transferred to storage. Now to withdraw this, just click on this and withdraw. It's easier than that. But to withdraw, you need some capacity in your inventory first. Like right now, I can only withdraw one card because my capacity is 930, right? So I cannot withdraw three cards because it will over limit my capacity. Yeah, that's how it goes. So you can keep as like 500 cards in the storage and more cards in your inventory. So yeah, this is good thing. Most people don't want to waste their Shinobites in just to increase the inventory limit. So you can, what you can do is store is 500 cards, the useless cards which you are not using, like these. old jutsus and stuff of old units which you are not using. You can just put them in storage and you will have some space left for your inventory, card inventory. Yeah, so there is that. Now mini games is here. Mini games, what you can, how can you play mini games? Just click on this igloo which is present here, and in front of this new Hokage statues. Just click on igloo, and yeah, I already played mine, so I cannot play it again. These are pretty simple, don't need explanation how to play. Yeah, and now let's go to Shinovite's pack. Yeah, Shinovite's pack are available. Lot of Shinovite packs are available with good cards, good stat cards. If you are like eager, if you want Shinovites and want to summon or stuff like that, then you can get these stat cards, good stat cards, 7 star stat cards, very good artwork. And yeah, get some tool also. And these special effect card is very good. This increases the ultimate jutsu and X ultimate jutsu power by 15%, especially for AOM. This is beneficial, so yeah, you can have a look at it if you are interested. This items pack is useless, don't look at it. Now special shop is really good. Like this is 500 Shinovite pack, which gives you like total of 1 2 3 4 5 6 hammers which you can use to make tools from the factory, the seal pickle tool, and this is the paralysis tool. So yeah, this is very useful. 500 Shinovite, if you can afford, then I would recommend you purchase this and make yourself some good tools, especially new players. This is also a ration. This is pretty cheap. Everyone should buy this. 75 Shinovites and you get a lot of good rations from here. You should save these for future purpose. Right now they are not that useful, but otherwise if you want in future, like in future if you are lacking some kind of attack power and stuff, then these can be useful. Same goes for this body beads pack, 5 star body beads pack. This is for 200 rupees. So yeah. Now what else? Exchange shop. Yeah, exchange shop, Shinobi cultivation exchange shop now has lot of stuff, like for example these items which are now usable, which are basically used for unlocking the path, link board path. If you go further down the link board, then you can use these. These are only these were only gainable through login bonus and the map mission in the special category section. So most people don't have a lot of maps, so you can now get these amulets and stuff from here as well. They have added a lot of hero gems, so this is a good time to get these Shinobi's hero gems if you are lacking. Especially Danzo, Shisui and a lot of others have been added here. So yeah, if you want, you can just play Shinobi cultivation mission and get you some hero gems. Okay, now yeah, new AOM tool. So yeah, I was browsing around factory and I saw that new AOM tool is here. The factory right now you cannot make it, of course, like it will gonna be coming after 10 days, then AOM will come and you can make like this tool after the rank rewards of AOM. So this is like paralysis tool and poison which has CP. So yeah, anyways, yeah, also one more thing, 6 star HP and 6 star attack speed is now available. It is not available to purchase from anywhere right now. I have not seen it from available for purchase. It is being given as roundup last two stages reward. So I will show you later. So this is like 6 star HP build. You can see 8000 to 13000 HP can give. So it's not available for shop yet. I haven't seen it anywhere. Like I was visiting a special shop and stuff, I did not see 6 star body beads material purchase. Yeah, only 5 star are available as of now. Good thing. Okay, so now let's go to the summon thing. Yeah, this banner is here, the anniversary banner. Drop rates are decent. If you have a lot of Shinovites, do summon on it. If you don't have a lot of Shinovites, I will recommend waiting. And when you summon on it, you get some tickets which you can use to summon either on Naruto or Sasuke. It's your wish. Now Neo Chief banner is here. You can check out the drop rate yourself. If you're interested, you can do this as well. Ticket is also here. 5 star, we got one ticket today. Maybe we'll get, if you remember, we saw this in login bonus, so we can get this ticket from login bonus as well. And this is also another anniversary ticket which gives 10 cards. Pretty good. And they have added new kind of Ryo summon which gives Ninja tool material. So this is also existing. This is new one. So you do Ryo summon and you get some kind of materials for Ninja tool and stuff. So yeah, this is new. Better than doing this, instead of doing this, do this, you will get sometimes good results. Anyways, they haven't updated ticket summon, so yeah, little sad about that. Anyways, now let's see, yeah, roundup battle. So now in all missions you can see stage info. Not only roundup, every stage you can now see stage info. What stage info tells you is how you have to go. Like now you don't have to figure out where to go, who to kill, who not to kill, gate crash and stuff. They are providing you the information on how the map will look like, who are the shinobis you have to use, and this works for every stage, not only roundup, like special missions and stuff. Every stage this works, every mission it works. Okay. Now also you can use this time, I don't know, it's anniversary special most probably. This time a lot of medium effect shinobis have been added, not only these two, and usually it should have been Indra, Asura, the Itachi and these two, but now what they have been, maybe this is because of anniversary. Let me show you. Yeah, large effect is of these three: medium effect, Indra, Asura, Naruto Light, Shadow Sasuke and War Sakura. So most probably this is because of anniversary, I guess. So yeah, these have medium effect. So you, if you don't have Indra, Asura, then you can use anyone from these three. It's medium effect. Yeah, these three are large effect. Okay, let me look. Roundup exchange shop. Yeah. Okay. Roundup exchange shop. Now they don't have the blue frogs. They have the gold frogs. This is good, I guess. And now they have bundled all the materials into one pack, which is really good because if you go like, let me show you how it used to look like last roundup shop. Yeah. Like previously they had blue one, right? This blue synth material, instead now we are giving green, bronze and gold, and they have combined these, yeah, these material shop, these evolution material into one pack, which is very good thing because now we can purchase everything in one go instead of clicking on every button one by one. Yeah, there's that roundup. Yeah, so now they have combine these, so you can just purchase everything from here, and yeah, pretty much the same as before. Up, yeah. Now solo, there is no super difficulty, but there is one stage which is kind of super difficulty. Now you can play these two stages, but you have to solo this with the given shinobi. Like this time, this stage is only soloable by this the final very Naruto. And if you don't have him, if you don't have his kit, you cannot do it because all the shinobis are restricted. You can see, you cannot use anyone except him. So you have to solo using him. It gives you key 5-star, sorry, 6-star HP bead and some kind of emblem, which I will show you where it is usable. Same goes for next stage. It is only usable by playable by Sasuke, Final Valley, and rest all are restricted. So you have to remove the restricted ones. Then only you can play, and you have to solo it. Anyways, it's not a hard stage, but it is, you need their kit to complete it. So yeah, also you get medals. From this stage you get a 6-star attack bead and Sasuke medal. So what this medal is useful for is you can just go to title and select this, and it will show you your profile. That's all. Yeah, it's kind of like the Gokunin medal. Once per day Shinobi cultivation mission is here. If you want to, you see, I already did it. So once a day you can do that. It gives you dumplings and chakra and stuff. And also, if you are lacking on chakra, do these missions. They have a lot of chakra. Okay, now treasure hunting mission is also here. I haven't played this yet. It gives lot of items if you are lucky, and gives you 10 shinobites as well. Once it's one clear for one day, as usual. Doesn't have 6-star HP builds or attack builds. Let's see, attack medals and summon tickets doubled. Yeah. So campaign is going on, which I saw here. Fortress attack week. So this week, like the tickets and medals which you get from rewards are doubled. Yeah, this is good. Daily achievement have been doubled. This daily achievement which used to give 5 shinobites, now you can get 10 shinobites and double the chakra and Ryo as well. Ninja tool. If you want to like increase your inventory, instead of 10 shinobites, it's 5 shinobites. So it's a good time to expand your inventory limit. You are looking to expand it. Same goes for factory. Instead of 10 shinobites, now you can use 5 shinobites to expand your factory limit as well. Factory tools limit. Okay, half LP in special missions. Yeah, we have now half LP. If you remember, this was 15 LP, now it's 7. So yeah, you can see it's half. Only in special mission, not in roundup. Roundup is still the same as before, like 30 and stuff. you might be seeing one kind some number on top of, if you see on top of POW, it is says one. So what it means is one path is fully unlocked. So for Manaru Kage, my path one is complete, path two is still pending. I haven't unlocked these two keys, so that's why it is not showing two. Otherwise it would have shown two here. So now it's showing one. That means I have unlocked the path one completely of this shinobi. Same goes for part 2 and part 3 as well. So yeah, now link board part 3 is only available for this Naruto and the new Sasuke. So part 1 and part 2 are normal, normal as you everyone does it, you have to unlock using normal key. But part 3 you need special key. You see this special key, this is called hero key. So this key is only available from summoning. So if you go to the details of this summon banner, and it's step round 3, step 3 I guess. Yeah, round 3, step 3, we get Naruto Uzumaki final showdown, hero keys 20. And round 4, step 1, we get Sasuke Uchiha hero keys 20. And same at some other steps also. So this is very bad thing actually. You cannot unlock part 3 of the shinobi unless you summon very deep into the banner. I'm not liking this. So yeah, it has some pretty cool effects. Like has some, you can check it out yourself. Lot of stuff has been given, but again, you need that special key to unlock part 3. Anyways, at least I guess you can at least, if you unlock part 2, then little bit of part 3 is available to unlock for free, like these and these. But after that, you will need the key. Same goes for Sasuke, not only Naruto. Now, limit break. People are asking, why don't you limit break your jutsu? For limit break, you need one more copy. Like not one more, basically, you can limit break this 3 times. For the maximum effect. So this card needs, like if you get duplicates of this card, don't synthesize it, use it for limit break. Synthesize using normal frogs. You need level 8 jutsu in order to limit break, since this Sasuke card of mine is not level 8, it's level 1, so I cannot limit break it. And this one Naruto is level 8, I can limit break it, but I need one more copy of his jutsu, which I don't have. So for limit break, you need this copy as well as these blue books, which are only available right now from login bonus and summoning on the banner. And what limit break is actually quite good if someone can have it. Like as normally the cooldown is 8 seconds, but if you limit break, you can get it up to like 5 seconds, and CP cost is also reduced and damage is also increased most probably. Yeah, damage is increased. And limit break 2 is second time you limit break it, you will be able to reduce the enemy's invincibility by 3 seconds. Third time you limit break, the above effect is already there, plus 30% damage again attack taps. So red units will deal 30% more damage with this jutsu because this jutsu has limit break in it. So what this means is invincible by 3 seconds. For example, Rin gives 10 second invincibility to all the 4 final rope. Now you use this Kurama jump jutsu, Kurama tail beast bomb jutsu. Their invincibility time instead of 10 goes to 7 seconds. I think it's gonna get piled up. So if you use it again, then 7 will convert into 4. So by the time you convert it into 4, because this is a 5 second cooldown, you have to keep in mind this is 5 second cooldown. So once you used it, invincibility time reduces to 7. Then after you use it, so invincibility time totally goes to 0. So this is pretty dangerous thing. Basically, invincibility is a joke now because this reduces the invincibility. If you can limit break this jutsu, you are gonna be so OP. This jutsu is gonna be so OP. It's already so OP, but now it's gonna be even better than that because of limit break. So I don't know what. Now defense is gonna be like losing a lot because of this, because people were relying on invincibility a lot. Like for example, my defense, Madaraj, Raya, Hashirama all had invincibility jutsu. Now they are just useless. So yeah, because they all have like 2 second invincibility, and if I use this jutsu, that invincibility will be removed. So I don't know. So same goes for Sasuke as well. Like Sasuke has some similar effect on his limit break as well, but I don't have his copy, so I cannot do that for him as well. He is 30% damage against utility taps. Utility is yellow most probably. So yeah, he will be doing more damage to yellow units, and Naruto will be doing more damage to red unit because Naruto is yellow and Sasuke is red. So I think they mix and match those conditions. So yeah, that's it for limit break. It's not that big a deal. like it's not hard to understand. It is what it is. What I will do is I have written this all down in a notepad. I will copy paste this in description as well, so that you can refer it while watching this video if you want to. And yeah, I guess I covered everything else. These are great units. So if you have a lot of Shinobites, like 5000 plus Shinobites, then I would really recommend you summoning a little bit on these two. Then wait for anniversary on December 10th to summon on the part 2. Yeah, collect little bit now, summon little bit now, and then summon little bit later. Anyways guys, thanks for watching this video. I hope this clears things for you. I will try to record this video as much as I can, which I don't think it's possible because it's already 20 minutes. And yeah, and hope I covered everything in the anniversary part 1. If I missed something, please do let me know in the comments. Then I will make a pinned comment if something I have missed. So yeah. Also, I will be putting one clip for you of Naruto Ultimate and Final Room, so you can watch that also. See you next time. Have another.